New WikiLeaks cable set to reveal U.S. UFO war in Southern Ocean. This is dated April 14th, 2011. A new report circulating in the Kremlin today, prepared for President Medvedev by Russian Space Forces, VKS 45th Division of Space Control, says that an upcoming WikiLeaks release of secret U.S. cables details that the Americans have been engaged since 2004 in a war against UFOs based on or near the continent of Antarctica, particularly the Southern Ocean. According to this report, the United States went to its highest alert level on June 10, 2004, after a massive fleet of UFOs suddenly emerged from the Southern Ocean and approached Guadalajara, Mexico, barely 1,600 kilometers or 1,000 miles from the American border. Prior to reaching the U.S. border, however, this massive UFO fleet is said in this report to have dimensionally returned to their Southern Ocean home base. The fears of the Americans regarding these Southern Ocean UFOs began, this report says, during the unprecedented events of July 11, 1991, which is actually referred to as 7/11, when during the solar eclipse, these mysterious aircraft appeared by the hundreds over all of Mexico. Even their capital city. Most notable about the events of 7/11 were that as millions of Mexicans were watching on their televisions the national broadcasts of these UFOs over Mexico City, the American media refused to allow their people to view it. Well, let's get that straight. It's not the media, it's who controls the media and who owns the media. Since 2004, this report continues. Fleets of Southern Ocean UFOs have continued to emerge from their bases, with the latest such event bringing this Friday past when another of their massive fleets was sighted over the South American nation of Chile. The immediate danger to our world when these massive UFO fleets emerge from the Southern Ocean, this report warns, are the massive waves caused by their sudden eruption from what are believed to be their underwater base or bases. In the past week alone, the Clelia 2, an Antarctic cruise ship with 160 people on board, was nearly capsized when hit by waves generated by these UFOs emerging from the Southern Ocean, and just today the number one Insung has been reported sunk, with only 20 of its 42 member crew said save due to the same cause. Interesting to note in this report is it's confirming our October 14th report, U.S. shuts down New York City airspace over UFO threat, that these same Southern Ocean UFOs were responsible for the closing of the airspace over New York City this past fall, October 13th, when they appeared openly and were witnessed by tens of thousands of people, and which coincidentally occurred during the same time frame as the mysterious crystal skulls of the ancient Southern American peoples were being exhibited there too. Even more interesting to note is that the mysterious earthquakes being reported in the Gulf of Aden, where another extraterrestrial event is currently ongoing, and we had reported on our December 1st report, mysterious vortex warned is creating global weather catastrophe, are now being reported occurring in the Southern Ocean too. Report goes on to state that after WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange warned last week that he would begin releasing secret U.S. cables relating to these Southern Ocean UFOs and the Americans' war against them, he was immediately arrested by British police on trumped-up charges issued by the Swedish government, which in our December 8th report, Global Rebellion Erupts After Unprotected Sex Meets Disrobed Governments, we noted, were engineered against him as a classic CIA honey trap. Okay, I won't go into any more about that, but just thought that was interesting. You know, I'm so sick and tired of, you know, having to read things that are being reported in other countries. And here we think that the United States is the best country on the planet. The best country in the entire planet. And we have been lied to and dummied down. And right now we're sheep to the slaughter. We're giving every country on the planet all of our money that we have worked hard for. People are killing themselves because they have lost their homes. People are having to move back in with their antique parents because they don't have anywhere to go with full families. Alcoholism is up 500% in the United States because people are getting little glimpses of how they've been betrayed and how there is no justice. We have open borders that are being supported by the government. They're even paying them to bring trade of trucks from Mexico up into the United States. I mean, that's all fine, but these trucks, they don't have any kind of smog requirements in their country or nothing. So our government's giving each truck that brings in a load of drugs or whatever the hell they're paying them to bring here, drugs, they're paying these guys $10,000 per truck so that these trucks will meet U.S. standard requirements for vehicle emissions. I mean, it just goes on and on and on and on. You know, I'll tell you, I've known this stuff since I was a kid. I never got into politics because I knew as a little girl, a little child, when the President of the United States had his head blown off, I knew that there was something wrong. There had to be a reason why that was happening, because he was a nice guy, or so he appeared. You know, it's just been one of those things I just really don't want to know. But now I need to know. And I'm not going to give up and say, well, I don't have anywhere to go and I don't know what to do and I'm filled with fear. Hell no. There are plenty of people here on YouTube who are willing to help you find a place to go, tell you where the safe places are. I've had several people extend their heart and their generosity. And I'm telling you right now, we are headed for a full-blown blackout on these computers. Full-blown. Any day, I expect it. So my suggestion is, we're going to have to go back to old school. Hardline telephones. And mail. You know, if you have some questions with somebody, get their phone number and start talking to them and start networking that way. Because, first of all, you're going to do without all the shills and everything else. You can talk one-on-one openly with other people who are more than happy to share information. I mean, if I didn't live at the beach in Southern California, I would open up my house. I probably would have already had it filled with Japanese people. You know, I'm just saying, This is what it's going to have to come down to, is old school. Meeting somebody, looking at them in the eyes and saying, you know what? We're kindred spirits. We're going to get through this. And this is how we're going to do it, together. So, you know, I'm sorry, I just needed to rant. And I'm not done. I'm actually pissed. I am pissed off. And when I get pissed off, I get busy. So anyway, God bless.